Hello, everyone. This is your host of the Immigrant Experience Show, Moji Taiwo, coming to you from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. In our new episodes of the Immigrant Experience Show, under TMT Learning Foundation, we will be bringing the stories of successful immigrants in Canada to you monthly. And we also have a new segment called What You Need to Know. This What You Need to Know will feature immigration issues, education issues, parenting issues, anything that we feel that it's important for the immigrant family to know in Canada. So look out for the new Immigrant Experience Show under TMT Learning Foundation. Hello, welcome back to the Immigrant Experience Show with Moji Taiwo. We're here coming to you from Calgary, Alberta, Canada. And this is part two of our interview with our creative Mindz and Kulture College, Kulture Institute of Cosmetology. But, you know, we got it the first time, we'll get it again the second time. Welcome back, Gladys.
Thank you.
So, we want to know more about your business.
Yes.
And how unique you've created this space, not only for the people that are coming in as clients, mm-hmm. but also with for the people that works with you on our on part one of our series here. You talk favorably and warmly about your staff, and you know that says a lot about you as a leader and as a person and as a business person, because it's critical to be welcoming to everyone when you are in business. So we want to continue that dialogue. You told us where you started. You know, I think this is the fourth layer of your business journey. You recently launched the Cosmetology Institute of Cosmetology.
That's right.
So that will be your latest achievement.
Yes.
So I want you to tell us more about what goals do you have and what do you need to achieve those goals, and how can we, you know, the TieShow and our, you know, audience,
yes,
help you achieve those goals. Yes. First, what other goals do you have?
First and foremost, thank you for this opportunity. Like, every opportunity to talk about my business is just so honorable, you know, and I appreciate it quite well, because now I have the opportunity to, you know, send the message across to even a bigger audience.
Oh, yes,
so thank you so much. And if you are listening, I really appreciate Moji Taiwo. She's an awesome woman, you know, and I see what you're doing as well. I know you asked me a question, but the first one, I was talking about seeing people who are ahead. As much as you want to bring people behind you, it's always good to also, like, who are you looking up to? Yes, so you're one of
Thank you. We're not here to talk about me today, though. Yeah.
Yes.
But thank you. I really appreciate that. And you are right. People ask, what's your end goal with this show? My end goal is to elevate people.
Yes.
And to make noise for our people, because if we don't tell our stories, who's going to tell it?
Yes. So with Cosmetology Institute, first of all, I started with Creative Mindz Beauty Center. And Creative Mindz Beauty Center, the vision behind it is to have a space. And that's why the name changed from Perfect Touch and Gladys Beauty to Creative Mindz, because I wanted to, even the name of it, to encompass more people. Yes. So, and after we did that, that was after COVID.
Mm-hmm.
And it became very successful, that a lot of people were identifying with, you know, Creative Mindz. They see it as a place of growth,
mm-hmm.
a place where they can partner you know, with the business, those that are planning to close their businesses because they've been doing it, you know, for such a long time, and because of the overhead, they're looking to scale down.
Mm-hmm.
I opened it up as a place instead of letting those talents die. Like some people will just close their business, mm-hmm. you won't hear anything about them. Mm-hmm. But I wanted to see a little part of what everybody is doing in Creative Mind, so we can build like this wholesome, you know, beautiful place.
And it is wholesome. You see the picture of it. It's very wholesome.
Especially, you know, for our own people, you know, and haven't succeeded. One of the struggles, because you asked for a lot of the challenges in the first interview,
mm-hmm.
one of the struggles that I have encountered, especially in the past, since I've been in the beauty industry, is finding people.
Mm.
And I find that unlike back home in Nigeria, where I'm from, a lot of people will learn how to do hair, even on the street. My mom knew how to do hair, but she wasn't a hairstylist. All my sisters could do hair. None of them were hairstylists. I also could do hair, but I wasn't really a hairstylist back home. I was a biology teacher. I only started doing hairstyling because of the need that I saw.
Again, a biology teacher turned hairstylist, beauty magnet, and wellness.
Yes.
You know, expert.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, we go through this journey when we talk to immigrants, and we find that one thing always leads to another, which also is a message to new people and young people,
yes.
that don't pigeonhole yourself.
Right.
You are a whole being with so many talents to discover.
Mm-hmm. So true. So when I started Creative Mind, I couldn't find hairstylists to hire. I couldn't find them. It's not even about how much you want to pay them. We couldn't find them. You can find like a braider, because back home you knew how to braid, but that doesn't translate into being a hairstylist,
mm-hmm.
because there are other care part of being a hairstylist that you just braiding hair or twisting hair does not equip you to do. You need to like...
You have the special training.
Training, yes.
How to mix chemicals.
Yes.
Apply chemicals.
Exactly. So, and being that I was fortunate enough, after attending a hair school here in Calgary, when I attended the hair school, I already knew how to do black hair.
Mm-hmm.
So doing black hair wasn't one of the reasons why I went to hair school. I went to hair school with an excitement to actually learn how to do straight hair,
white hair, and other people's hair.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So to me at the time, it wasn't...
You expanded your knowledge.
Yes. Yes. So hair school, of course, taught me how to do white hair. And I could say I'm very good at doing white hair as well,
mm-hmm.
you know, because I really wanted to learn. But what I find that when people who are here, not just people, students and the young ones that are growing up here in Calgary, here in Canada, or even other parts of the world, that do not have the same opportunity as I did back home to learn black hair. Now they go to hair school and learn white hair. But if you look at the beauty center, I wanted to create a space where we can also take care of black people. So when they graduate, yes, they have licenses. They've been professionally trained, but they cannot work with black hair. Any natural curly hair, they cannot work with this hair, mm-hmm. even though they are black.
Mm-hmm.
So look at the irony. Most times, other businesses will hire them because of their skin color. Mm-hmm. They are black.
Mm-hmm.
With the intention that they could do black hair.
And only then they find out that just because they're black doesn't mean that they have not been trained in it.
Because they have not been trained.
And they are born here.
And they are born here.
So they didn't have that
same
birth training,
yes.
of braiding here from the time that they're little kids.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. So, like, when they come, I'm like, okay, most of our clients, 70% of them are people with naturally tight, curly hair. And you don't have this training, then I have to, first of all, train you for such a long time,
mm-hmm.
before I could even hire you. But because I was already a professional, I was a trained teacher, mm-hmm. to begin with, hair, mm-hmm. or hair.
Yes, so yes. That ties into the next thing, is that it doesn't matter what your original training or education is, you always come around and use it. It's always useful.
It's always useful.
It's always useful.
Yes. So I'm very grateful for that. So because of that, I went back to the hair school. I'm like, look, we are having students that are going into workplace that cannot even, they can't be hired. If they hire them, they will be fired. It's just a matter of time. Give them a month or two, they will be fired because they don't have the skills to cater to everyone. So can we, what can we do with the curriculum to make sure that black hair or Afro textured hair is in the curriculum? And the school told me that it is not them, it's the government.
Okay.
That is the government that issues out the curriculum that set the standard, you know, that they are not the ones. I'm like, okay. So I went back to the government. So that's why I'm like a little rebel in the industry. Because no, I'm well, like, why?
Well, you have to have a rebellious streak in you in order to achieve what you want to achieve.
Yes.
Passion, persistence, and a little bit of stubbornness to achieve,
So I started, you know, liaising with the government, the apprenticeship office. I'm like, look, we have a big problem. How can we do to add, you know, more black hair in the curriculum? I mean, it's still an ongoing conversation. And I've been, actually, they are coming around because they said, a lot of people haven't come to them to say this problem exists. So that's why.
Even though they know based on their own statistics that immigration of non-Caucasians are rising, yet they're waiting for somebody to come and tell them that they need to change their curriculum to meet the needs of the growing demography.
Exactly.
Interesting.
Yes, so that was what I did. And right now, I'm in a stage where I've designed a curriculum. It has met the standard of Alberta. The curriculum itself has been approved.
Excellent.
That's one victory.
Yes.
The second victory, the second, okay, yes, it's a victory by faith. But the second part is that they are like, okay, Gladys, yes, we can now see what you've designed. This, we can work with it. But who else in the industry
can support
to see
you.
This? So that's where I answered a petition online to say people to sign up. And I'm even going from other hairstylists. So I even started a WhatsApp group. And I invited other hairstylists to have this conversation. This will not just be for me.
No.
It's for the generation, preserving our heritage.
And generations, you know,
to come. Yes. And if this bill gets passed, like they said, it will take at least 10 years for it to be amended. So they cannot just change, you know, the policy. Because I have come out to say there is this need. They want to hear from other people in the industry. So please, I am... pleading with everyone, like you asked me how you can help. If you are in the beauty industry, either you're a beautician, barber, esthetician, you're in the beauty industry and you're a professional, because they want to hear specifically from professionals. You know, not just people doing it part-time at home, you know. So they want to hear from you.
And these people will have to come from Calgary, Alberta, or Canada-wide?
Canada-wide.
Okay.
But Alberta mostly. The policy and the bill will be passed in Alberta. So it will affect Alberta only. Because that's what I'm like advocating for.
Yes.
And if that works, other
provinces... we're going to put a link on the video. We'll put a phone number on the video where you can reach out to... inquire about the petition and be a part of the solution to our, you know,
curriculum,
our heritage moving forward.
So that's what is going on as we speak right now. Once that is done and they can see that there are more people and not just black people.
No, I was going to say non-Caucasian because Hispanic people have curly hair. Asian people have curly hair.
That's right.
Arabic people have curly hair.
Yes.
So,
Yeah. So please, they really want like a letter of support. I have a survey and also a letter of support.
Okay.
Just to say that, yes, you support this movement. You support the mission to see a curriculum and to also see a career path. That's... covers naturally curly textured hair.
All right.
And that's so when culture was born. So my hair school now has been open, is running, is online, cultureinstitute .ca. You know, so what we do is we started offering trainings.
Yes.
You know, to people who are already maybe in the beauty industry but don't have the skills. So if you already have your licenses but you need the skill, you don't need to get another license. Mm-hmm. You just need to go on our website. We'll have a course for you, super interactive. You can do it from the comfort of your home, or you can also come into the, you know, the school. We have, and that's why we have all these mentors and people who have been stylists who have been in the industry for over 30 years, 20 years.
So it's all built in. It's a one-stop shop.
Yes.
You get the training to complement your license.
Yes.
And then you come in and you have real life mentors.
Exactly. And that's what I want the students to leverage on.
Mm-hmm.
When they take the course online, we try to also have the mentors do videos, very, very interactive videos to demonstrate some skills.
Mm-hmm.
And that is for people who are not able to come in. If you're able to come in, you can also come in and do the practicum
in person.
Well. So okay. We are not limiting to only online. Online is just to make sure that people who are not in Calgary, they are not able to come in, can also have access.
And this courses is not limited to just people in Calgary, in Alberta,
anywhere in the world.
You can also take the training.
That's right.
Yeah. Well, wonderful.
So thank you.
Wonderful. Yes.
But
you also have one more thing coming up.
Yes.
Which we cannot forget.
Yes. So every summer I run the Afro Textured boot camp. So this is for youth, for teenagers. And one thing about me, I have a big heart for our teenagers. Because a lot of them started with me in Creative Minds. Their parents will always bring them when they are young. Like I said, I've been here for almost 15 years. So I've seen them from when they were like 8 and they are in the unis now.
Mm-hmm.
And most times they'll call me, leave me text message in the middle of the night. Auntie Gladys, what's the product you used to use on my hair? What is this called? Can you show me how to do my hair? Mm-hmm. Can you help me? I have this problem. It's always unending. So because of that, the boot camp was born, summer boot camp. So every summer for 4 weeks, This year.
What are the dates? August what?
August, so it's every Monday. Mm-hmm. Four Mondays. The whole Mondays in August, that's when it's happening.
Okay.
The four Mondays in August is 10 to 4 p.m.
Yes.
You come in here, it's more hands-on. That's what we call it, a boot camp.
Boot camp,
so
yeah.
So morning to evening, you will learn how to braid, you will learn how to do cornrows, how to do shampoos, conditioner, how to detangle your hair.
Mm-hmm.
Products to use. The right equipment. Mm-hmm. So even if you are in Spain studying, you don't have to wake up looking on camp.
Yes.
You know, your mental state, build confidence, just make you feel so happy that you can just wake up and do something on your hair. And
where can they register?
They can register online, also on cultureinstitute.ca.
Yeah.
There's a link there where it says summer braiding bootcamp registration. Just click on it. All the information you need is right there.
cultureinstitute.ca, not com, .ca, we're in Canada.
That's right. Mm-hmm. And another bonus to it is that a lot of the students that have gone through me, that are now in the uni, the feedback is that now they can trade services, so they don't need to pay for their hair, because they can do hair as well.
Yes.
And you know, for those of you who attended boarding school, if you cannot do hair, nobody will do your hair.
We traded.
Trade services.
Yes.
And then they say they are even making extra income. They don't have to bother their parents. They don't have to depend on boyfriends that they don't like to give them money, because I don't want to ask. Yes, it's a big part of it. So it also gives them something to do to just, you know, keep their mental health and state of mind just lively. And then they get to meet people. Mm-hmm. It's amazing.
It is.
So because of the feedback, I will always run it every summer.
All right.
Ages 9 to 17.
Yes. Girls?
Girls
and boys. Yeah, I was going to say, because boys can barber too.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
I had boys, second one, I had boys. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
So it's for boys and girls. Yeah.
Yeah.
One. Again, it's inclusive.
Yeah, every gender. As long as you want to learn hair.
Yeah.
I'm not biased about gender at all.
No.
Just come as you are.
Yes.
As long as you want to learn.
So, we're going to once again try to wrap it up. If you are to summarize and you have a few nuggets to immigrants mm-hmm. and non-immigrants. Well, mostly immigrants mm-hmm. that are coming in, because we have a lot of people coming in mm-hmm. in different ages yeah. and demography. Mm-hmm. What will be one or two critical advice mm-hmm. you will offer to them?
I would like to say this. Everyone has something to offer. When you're coming in, I know a lot of people have the mindset that they want to find out what is working, what everybody is doing. What is it that makes money? What do you have to offer? Look within. Always start from within. Mm-hmm. There's always something that you have to offer that nobody else can offer.
Yeah.
Nobody else have seen. Mm-hmm. Nobody else knows about.
Mm-hmm.
Something that makes you unique to yourself. When I was coming in, I didn't know I was going to be doing hair. But hair is something that I enjoyed doing. I did it from back home. I would do hair because I'm bored. I would do hair because I'm broke. I would do hair because I want to meet people.
Mm-hmm.
But look at it now. It becomes something that you can't even convince me to do anything else. So always look within you. Within you. What is it that you can offer that brings you joy?
That brings you joy. It goes back to that passion.
Yes.
It brings you joy mm-hmm. and you have a talent for.
Yes.
And it just makes you unique.
Yeah. And nobody else has seen that part of you. Look mm-hmm. at us. Our faces are not the same.
No.
So I believe that there's something everyone has that nobody else has.
Yes.
Even if they have it, maybe a similar mm-hmm. or maybe a different version
of it.
But you might be the original copy.
Mm-hmm.
So don't always look outside to see what
that's it. Because people want to grab, as opposed to, you said it at the beginning, what do you have to offer? While you are offering, then benefits will come from us unsuspecting spaces.
So true, yes.
Yeah, so mm-hmm. people have to look at their unique gifts, their unique talents, mm-hmm. and what is it that they have to contribute? Yes.
And sometimes, another thing I'll add, it mustn't even be monetized at the first time. When I started making hair, I would just go to church and ask ladies, I can make your hair. Are you a hairstylist? No, but I can make your hair look better than what you have. That's always my line.
Yes.
Whatever I can make you look better.
Yeah.
So that was how the business actually started. But that wasn't a strategy. I said, okay, this is what I would do.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of people are fine. They have an idea that hasn't even been nurtured or built, but they want to monetize it
right away.
I'm like, show people what you can do. The money will come. They started paying me before I asked for money. I would say, just tip me whatever you want,
because they like what the service you offer them.
They thought it was valuable.
Yes. And other people have probably complimented them.
Yes.
So they saw value in it. Yes.
Trust me, I will pay you if you do my. I'm like, no, I don't. But I will pay you. Because the first time I didn't ask for money.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't, again, a strategy I wanted to adopt. But I'm saying it now that you can adopt that strategy as well. A lot of people won't pay for things that hasn't been tested.
Yes.
You know, yes. So be kind enough to give without expecting anything.
Hey, there goes my book title again. I give because I'm blessed.
Yeah.
I'm blessed because I give.
Right.
You said it. Just give. Yes.
Give.
Yes.
Don't expect anything. If the universe wants it, they will chase you with money to pay you for it. But just give.
Yes.
You know, if you are giving, it's free. You have more people that are interested. And that's a way to also learn to see what works.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
So money can be a barrier.
Mm-hmm.
Money can be a barrier.
When that's all we are chasing.
Yeah, especially when you're coming in mm-hmm. and you want to leverage, make money, it can mm-hmm. always be a barrier.
Mm-hmm.
So work like from giving it freely.
Mm-hmm.
And if you have a calling, you will see it.
Because now
you have an audience.
Yes, yes.
You know, to practice on.
Thank you so much. So we're going to leave it there for now, but it's been a pleasure. If we continue to talk, we can tell. Yeah, you love talking. You make it easy for me to interview you. Yes. Yeah, it's been a pleasure. Thank you for welcoming us into your space. It's a beautiful space, and we also ask people to come to come and visit. It's not enough that you see it online. It's great that you're going to see it online because if you're far away, but if you're within the vicinity of Calgary and South Calgary, or, you know, Okotoks, High River, Airdrie, you know, come check this place out. You come in and you won't want to leave. You won't want to leave. It's beautiful. Thank you again.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Salon, yes. To be here with
Thank you.
You.
Thank you to our viewers, our supporters. We want you to please like, share, subscribe, and give us a comment from time to time. Until next time, we'll see you.